given to Bobby Richardson, a standout second baseman for the Bombers for 12 seasons during the 50s and 60s. Richardson's 209 hits in 1962 led the American League. A seven-time All-Star who won five Gold Gloves, he was a classic team player who always made others around him better.
He was a great influence on all the players he played with or against. He rarely missed a game. He was not tall as far as stature, and yet he had some 200 hit seasons. His name's in the record book in the 60 World Series, along with names like Mantle and DiMaggio and Ruth, and even ahead of them in some slugging categories in that one ball game. But I think character first, very quiet, unassuming, a leader. Some say he was part of one of the best infielders ever assembled. I'll leave the historians to say that. But it was comforting to me to see Bobby on my left, Cleetbore on my right, and across the diamond, Pepitone after he replaced Bill Scourin.
Two out in the last of the ninth inning. McCovey hits a sinking liner just one step to Richardson's left. The Yankees win and reign as world champs of 1962.
A gentleman who I really enjoyed playing with, made it easy for me at first base was Bobby Richardson. He's a quiet guy, and we were like really opposites at that time because I, as you know, liked to go out, and Bobby liked to stay home and do what he had to do. He was what we called like the preacher on the club. And so I tried to stay away from him. We didn't get that close, but he was a great ball player. He made it easy for me to play the game of baseball. Playing first base, he would talk to me and tell me how to play the position, the way to move over on certain hitters. So he was a big help to me.
Bobby was an excellent player. He could hit and run. You couldn't throw a fastball by him. He could steal a base, even though we weren't playing in a base-stealing era. And they compare him to Mazeroski, and I think very favorably. Some say Mazeroski might be the quickest on the double play ever. That's always debatable. I could say the same thing about my partner, Bobby Richardson, because he was as quick as they came. Terrific range. Went back on pop-ups, came in on bunts. He could squeeze if you were on third base and get a runner. And he did a lot of things as a baseball player. But I think the main thing that everybody talks about, in fact, when Roger Maris died, one of the first persons that Pat, Roger's wife, called with Bobby to come to North Dakota and give the eulogy. And leave it to Mickey, who was there, to come out and say, look, Bobby, when I die, I want you to do my eulogy too. That's how good you are. He said it lightly, but he really meant it.
And he was always a fine example for the youth of our country. And in my eyes, he's therefore a Hall of Famer off the field. And he's absolutely the pride of the Yankees. And we are going to go to a video right now, so I think we have a video. Here's your pride of the Yankees.
You know, just a word. When I was 14 years old playing American Legion baseball in Charlotte, North Carolina, playing against Richmond, the winner of that game would go to the American Legion World Series. They took our team out to see a film. And the name of the film was Pride of the Yankees, the story of Lou Gehrig. And Gary Cooper, of course, played the part of Lou Gehrig. It was a sad film, but a great organization, and I thought, man, I'd sure like to be a part of that. 5 years later, at 19, playing in Yankee Stadium, and then 10 years later, a day at Yankee Stadium, when I could say, as Gehrig said, how lucky it has been for me to have been a Yankee.
I'm proud to say, when they said, well, did you play Major League Baseball? Well, I played for the New York Yankees, and as soon as you say New York Yankees, right away when you're saying it, you think you're saying the best team in baseball. And I think that pride carried over into our play. I think Madeline Sittafield was a quiet leader. I think that whether it's Kubek, a Boyer, or whoever it might have been, the fact that they were a part of the Yankee team, there was a certain pride that gave you the impression that if you were behind the late innings, you could still win.
When I retired, I went into college coaching, and my idol was Phil Rizzuto. I looked up to him, and I coached his son at University of South Carolina, Whitey Ford's son. We finished second in the nation in the College World Series, and if Wade Boggs had come on and played with us, we'd have finished first in the nation. He signed, but then he went pro. I just want to say I had a great rapport with my teammates. I appreciate that. Had the privilege of representing all of the Yankees at Roger Maris's funeral, at Dick Howes's funeral, and baseball has been very good to me, and I appreciate very much this award and my years in baseball. George, thank you very much.